So welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a fat minute since I've been on here. It's been, I'd say, 3 weeks since I last uploaded. And honestly, it's just because life's been super fucking hectic. And honestly, I realize that it's just been me. But I was super stressed out and I tried vlogging so many times. I tried vlogging so many times and every time I just didn't feel it. Like, I didn't really want to be vlogging or there was nothing to vlog because I was really just running around doing a bunch of shit that I had to do in order to get my life together. And I wouldn't say my life is together at all, really. But I can tell when my life is falling apart. That's kind of weird. I can tell when my life is falling apart because I have to clean my room every day. When I'm doing good, when I'm on track, getting shit done, I clean my room like once or twice a week because there's really nothing to clean because I just put it back where it goes. But these past like 3 or 4 weeks, I've had to clean my room every day. So I clean it every freaking morning because every night it's a total mess again. So that's how I know like my life's been falling apart. And like I said, I've been stressed out and it never worked out okay. I did grab like a lot of things that some of these things I was vlogging at and some of these things I was just, I just caught. So go ahead and do a little update. So, let's see, what can I first start with? So vlogged getting my nails done. This was before Manny's, birthday, so I'll go ahead and like zoom through it. We're finally gonna get her fixed.
Zappy! Let me get my charger.
Okay. She scared me. Don't they look so motherfucking cute? The week of Halloween, we actually ended up carving pumpkins with Maite and Vince. So they bought the pumpkins and then me and my little sister went and we carved them.
I forget how I thought I could afford a Lexus. Vince, how is it going? Oh wait, we don't care about you anymore.
So on a video, oh, it actually looks nice. The unicorn, you can't really see it unless you know what the picture was. On a video unicorn.
No. Vince, we don't know what he did. And then I tried to make a fucking skull, but it looks like a fucking baby ET or something. It looks like a fucking alien.
That was fun. It was my first ever pumpkin carving. I've never carved a pumpkin before that. So if you see it, it's a little rough. Don't judge me. That weekend was Manny's birthday, and he actually ended up combining it with Cindy because they're birthday twins. So I was at that and that was a lot of fun.
Another one! What?
That shit was funny. I was like, oh dude, you can do this.
That was probably like the last time I'll ever go out and have fun and not have to worry about working, because if you did or did not know, I am back to being a working woman. Yeah, I went back to working, so that's kind of why my life's been falling apart. You know, you like, especially when because I have school, I can't let my schoolwork just sit there and like deadlines, you know what I mean? So that was like the biggest thing. I totally forgot that. So I am back to working, which means I have to like stay on track with schoolwork in order to go to work. Went to Manny's, a lot of fun. Manny, I'm gonna go drop that off like today or tomorrow because it's his fucking spooky basket from literally 2 weeks ago. Like, I should have given it to him 2 weeks ago. So Manny, if you're watching this, I'll go drop that off in a few days. The following Tuesday, I had my heels class. So I actually didn't end up vlogging that, but I'll go ahead and include that because I have that video.
Thank you.
that's where I've been. You know, I think a majority of it was just, I was just trying to enjoy my last few days that I was gonna be completely free on no one else's schedule but my own. So that's what I was doing, and I'm so glad it went that way. And actually today is something really exciting, so we'll go ahead and get into that. But it is currently, I didn't even introduce the fucking day. So today is the 9th of November. It's a Monday, and honestly, it's the first Monday in a few weeks where I felt like, yes, like this is Monday. I'm so excited. And that's also another thing about having a job, at least for myself. I feel like having a job really forces me to get my life together, forces me to stay on track, forces me to do what I need to do in order to get other things done. So I feel like that might be why this Monday is exciting. But like I said, it is Monday. It's a new freaking week, and I'm so freaking excited because I like having a schedule, okay? I like having a schedule. 11:02, I had my 9 a.m. class at 9, and I went ahead and did that, and then I just went ahead and turned in an assignment that was due at 1. And now we're gonna clean my room for like the third, what day is it, Sunday? Monday? I literally cleaned my room yesterday before I left to work, and now I'm cleaning it again because, like I said, my life is falling apart. I have like a week of laundry that I haven't fucking folded and like put in my closet. It's honestly a mess, but I have a schedule now. I have a schedule, okay? So let's just get this ball rolling. I'm gonna go ahead and clean my room. Let's go ahead and montage that. I'm so sorry about the shitty quality and the shitty lighting, but I'm in the car. It's currently 6:24. I basically just spent the day doing a bunch of schoolwork, and now we're here outside the gym. So the big, not announcement, but just like, oh my god, the coolest thing ever, I finally have a freaking car. And the story of how it came about is kind of long, so I can't say it right now, but maybe once I'm out of the gym, I'll go ahead and explain, and you can stick around if you're curious. I'm gonna go ahead and take my pre-workout shot, and I'll see y'all at the fucking gym. It's too much. I talked a lot, huh? I talked forever. Okay, yeah. So I actually ended up just peeing Baharle a little. I just recorded the part where I talked about, how this car came about, what even happened. So I'm literally just gonna cut to the chase. My dad cut me off and I got employed again, which means I need a car. I know a lot of you guys always saw me in a car. I mean, I was always fucking vlogging in the car. That car was not mine, it was my dad's, and I would just borrow it from him. Whenever I needed to run errands, or when I would go to the gym, or when I would need to do anything, I would just borrow it. But my dad said toodles, and so now I don't have a car. And I just got employed, so I need a car. My job is kind of a drive, so it wasn't like I could just Uber or something, or like even walk. I definitely needed a car. It was the longest process of my life. It's honestly, it was so freaking stressful. It was just super stressful just because I knew that I had to have a car before a certain day, and that just, it didn't seem to be happening. I went through my bank, I went through the dealership, I went through used cars, like I went through everything. And the biggest thing was, you haven't started at this job, and even though, you know, now I'm at that job, they needed pay stubs, and I didn't have them. So there was no way to get a loan or finance a car in any way, shape, or form, because no one was gonna take it. So basically what happened was that I paid off my mom's car, and now I have my mom's car. So my mom's car is actually mine. It is a Honda Civic 2017, and the reason why I took it was because it was honestly the best freaking offer I had. I mean, I had used cars, so I actually had this like money, this budget that I had. I basically used like more than half of my freaking life savings towards this car, and that was my plan for a used car. But then my mom told me, you know what, just I'd rather you pay off my car and keep that car, and I'll go finance another car than have you risk getting a car that is gonna come up with issues eventually. Like, I take really good care of my car. My car has little to fucking zero miles. Like, go ahead and just take it. For the money that you were gonna give to that used car, go ahead and just use that money, pay off my car, and keep the car. The car's yours, do whatever you want with it. So that's basically what I did. That's the story, okay? There was so much more into it. Dude, for a second, I thought, I didn't want to be, let me just say this part of the story, because I think this is like the funniest part. When I was looking for a car, when I was like thinking, because I didn't want to be biased towards any cars, like based off years or based off looks or based off like brands. I wanted a car that was going to get me from point A to point B. I'm talking really fast. So I actually ended up just looking on the streets. This was when I was going to get a car from the dealer. I was looking around the street and I was like, you know what, like what cars are cute? You know, that Honda kind of looks cute. That Hyundai kind of looks cute. And there was like a lot of cars that I was like, oh, those are kind of cute. You know, I was kind of putting my finger on it. That could be one of my options. And then the winner was a freaking Lexus, a white Lexus I saw out on the street. And I had actually talked to my just boyfriend about it, which fucking rain checked me. Was it rain check? No, fucking reality checked me. He reality checked me and told me that a Lexus was a luxury car, which I had no fucking clue about. Like, no, like zero, like no clue. Like, that's how you know I don't know cars, because I had no clue that a Lexus was like top notch, like luxury car AF. Like, a fucking Mercedes is cheaper than a Lexus. Like, I didn't know that. So for the first few days I was like, damn, like I'm really never gonna have a Lexus. But then eventually, like, it just became funny, because I'm like, dude, how did I think I could afford like basically a fucking Tesla? Like, I cannot, you know what I mean? So there was just that. But basically, yeah, that's how I got the car. And even though like I didn't really have any specific feelings towards my mom's car, it was kind of just like, I need a car, and that's the best offer I'm gonna get for what I'm willing to put down. Now that, you know, my money has gone to it and that car is mine because I paid for it, you know, I don't know, I love it. I'm attached. I might perhaps be a little attached, okay? And you know, like, I love it now, and that's my baby. It's gonna get me from point A to point B every single time I want to, you know what I mean? Like, I don't no longer have to rely on my dad. And that was another thing that, like, I know you guys always saw me you guys always saw me in the car while I was vlogging. Like, I feel like every car was a freaking car vlog. And that was because I borrowed it clearly a lot. And I mean, no one knows, but getting that car was always an argument with my dad because he's toxic. But yeah, it was just that, like, it was always an issue. So to no longer have to rely on my father to get me anywhere, you know, I feel like it's taken a big weight off my shoulders. And that's why I've finally had the chance to come on here and not be stressed and not worry. And like, yeah, like, having a car isn't the easiest thing, because now I have to look for parking, which, if you know where I live, there's never parking. So, you know, it's definitely gonna be a struggle, but it's just like, it's such a big blessing to be able to have a car. Like, a car is not a fucking right, it's a privilege. So I just feel super good. I'm super happy, I'm super blessed. Shout out to my mom because she came through. Shout out to Furby, who was willing to co-sign me. Shout out to Vince for helping me out through the car search. Like, he was the one that kind of knew about cars, so he was the one letting me know, like, this is a good deal, that's not a good deal, like, let me see if I can lower that price, like, blah blah. And then shout out to my thing for dating him. And yeah, that's gonna be my little story. I was gonna go into depth more into it, but really, like, it really doesn't matter. Like, that's, you get the point. And yeah, I'll go ahead and show you guys the car tomorrow. I just really wanted to get this part on here because if I don't do it today, I'll never do it. See you tomorrow. So it is the next day. It is a car tour. Not really a car tour. I mean, there's nothing really to show. It's just a car. I'll go ahead and show you guys.
This is the car dashboard. Is that what it's called? Fuck, I really don't know anything. And this is the car. Super fucking cute. My whole heart. I'm never gonna get over it. And then we were just playing that tiki, which is, you already know, the fucking vibe. And then that's... These are the back seats. I mean, there's nothing really fucking special about them. And then front seat. And yeah, let me go ahead and show you guys the outside. That's the front of the car. Side profile. Oh, shout out me. The back of the car for anyone that cares. Shout out car. I know, that's the new fucking whip, bitch. That's gonna be it for today's video. As always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to thumbs this video up if you did enjoy it. Also, don't forget to subscribe down below if you haven't already. And with that being said, I'll see you on my next vlog. Bye.